The Chief Minister said a fairly final protocol on Gibraltar, that's between the United Kingdom and the European Union, is not yet finalised, but there are not many points outstanding. Quoting the Spanish Foreign Minister, Josep Borrell, who said the negotiations were almost closed, Fabian Picardo said there was genuine reason for optimism and that there's no longer any question mark over Gibraltar's inclusion in any implementation period, nor any more talk of vetoes. He confirmed that beyond the protocol, there were a number of practical arrangements to be included in various memoranda of understanding. These, the Chief Minister said, would reflect cooperation in areas both sides had agreed as irritants, namely the rights of citizens, the environment, police and customs cooperation, trade in tobacco and a tax treaty. Mr. Picardo said a large measure of agreement on the substance of the memoranda had already been reached. On the airport, however, there was no change.
We have not found the PSOE government of Spain prepared to move to implement the arrangements agreed in Cordoba by the former PSOE government of Spain in this respect. The government of Gibraltar takes the view that the Gibraltar side has complied with its obligations under the Cordoba agreement, and we are ready to see it come into effect. Mr. Speaker, there will be no change or progress in respect of enhanced use in relation to Gibraltar Airport.
The Chief Minister reiterated Gibraltar would never compromise its sovereignty, jurisdiction or control, and in answer to a question put to him by Daniel Feetham, expanded on the opportunities for Gibraltar's future relationship with the EU, including possibly joining the customs union if the commercial price was right.
The government is also in parallel working towards a potential situation where Gibraltar has a permanent deal that may provide Gibraltar with more European Union than the UK desires for itself.
There may be the opportunity, which we have sought from the beginning, to have what I have termed a differentiated solution for Gibraltar. I think the choice to stay out of the customs union was absolutely the right one in 1972. I've said on a number of occasions already that I don't know whether it is the right conclusion in 2020 or 21 when we leave the European Union at the end of an implementation period. At that time, the view might be, and I think it's a view that I hope we will take together in this House, Mr. Speaker, or indeed in a future iteration of this House after the next general election, that the right conclusion might be that we have membership in some way, shape or form of the Common Customs Union and have access to it. Or it may not be, because there will be two sides to the coin. Some will think that they can set a price for that. And if it is a commercial price, well, Mr. Speaker, that's what nations negotiate about, and that's how you adjust your markets, and you do so in the way that is most sensible for your people.
Fabian Picardo stressed Gibraltar was still to make decisions in respect of what differentiated solutions it would seek. However, he said the frontier didn't just represent a commercial value, but also a human one. The Chief Minister said the implementation period would give the ROC the opportunity to negotiate a future that would be of mutual benefit and prosperity to the whole region. Brexit, however, wasn't the only subject on everyone's minds.
I think the whole House will want to join me in congratulating the Gibraltar Football Association for their magnificent home win on Tuesday evening against Liechtenstein, their second successive win in the UEFA Cup of Nations, and a moment, Mr. Speaker, of utter joy that propelled me to hug the person next to me when the whistle was blown, and it happened to be my predecessor as Chief Minister. So the magic of football, Mr. Speaker, knows absolutely no bounds.
Parliament will meet again on the 8th of November.